Okay, so I'm going to show you how to remove the people from the background of this picture. The technique I'm using for this is to use an additional picture that I took, and layer it over and then remove the pieces that have people in it. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm turning down the opacity and then I'm lining up the castles as close as I can get. I'm not actually keeping the castle from that second picture, but this helps just line up the street. I'm using the light eraser tool to erase just a bit of Mouselet 1 and part of me, Mouselet 2, just so I can kind of try to see how it's gonna look, make sure everything's lined up. So, not doing it perfectly, just erasing bits and pieces. So now I'm turning the opacity back up and I'm looking to see how it looks. I'm trying to match up the pavement, so I'm going to use the adjust colors tool. I'm going to increase the brightness and then I'm going to try to increase the blue a little bit by turning down the temperature and then decreasing the contrast just a little bit. Now it's a pretty close match, it's not exact, but it doesn't really have to be exact yet. Now I'm going to go back and I'm going to finish erasing. I'm going to turn the eraser tool down to be a little more precise. So the strength up and the size down, and try to get those edges perfectly. I just use my pointer finger to do this, so it's just one hand. It's really easy on a touch screen. This can also be done on Photoshop, and that's a little bit of a different technique, but this is all just done from my iPhone. It took me about 10 minutes to do it. You'll notice I hit part of the castle behind Mouselet 1's bow. I'm gonna erase this castle so it doesn't really matter if I'm not getting exactly in this area because I'm gonna use the castle from the original photo. So now I'm going on to my own hair. I'm missing pieces of it that have a color behind it. See, that blue shirt would be really obviously behind it, so I'm just gonna skip those pieces, and if it looks weird after, then I'll make the change then. I generally don't like to layer two pictures over another unless I have to. I prefer to just try to remove people or just leave them in, but sometimes if you want to print it out on a canvas or you want to have a nice memory without people, it can be nice to use another picture if it was just too busy. So I'm wrapping up with the erasing, and I'm going to turn the opacity up in a minute, and you'll see that there were a couple flaws that I left behind. It's hard to tell sometimes, so when I turned it up, you can see that on my face there's still remnants of, you know, whatever was there, so I'm going to go back to the erasing tool and erase those pieces. So now I increase the size and decrease the strength because I'm taking away the castle in the sky, but I'm still going to leave bits and pieces of it that had too many people in it. So right here, kind of have to zoom in to make sure I'm getting around the tree properly. And I want to leave that tall castle tower. I also want to keep the sky from my original photo. So that's why I'm erasing most of the sky. Now I'm blurring the background of that second photo I put in because the original photo I took was on portrait mode on my camera, so blurring it will make the backgrounds match more exactly. And then I'll finish up just the final details. So there are two people in the photo that I had laid over it, and I want to remove them, so I'm going to use the clone tool. Gets a little messy because it's blurred. So I'm going to use the clone tool. You drag the little plus sign to the spot that you want the new area to be copied, and then you just kind of paint over it with your finger, and it does take a little bit of practice to just move it around and get it in the right spot. Another technique that could work if you didn't want to remove them would just be to select the color of this red shirt and just make it a grayscale. The red really stands out and a gray would blend in a lot better, but I chose to remove them completely. I'm almost done now with removing the boy, then I'm going to remove the girl, which is a little quicker, and finish up on some smaller details. I keep zooming out just to see, sometimes you can leave little imperfections if it's, you know, really far out, so that's why I'm zooming in and out. You can see it looks a little bit messy still, so going and using the color select tool, and then I decided that actually wasn't the best. I was going to use the rectangular selection instead, dragging out that smoother finish, and then I'm going to have to fix those edges because otherwise it looks really obvious. So now I'm going back to the clone tool and I'm just going to kind of smudge those edges using it. So I'm pretty much done, but then I realized that there's actually people's legs in between our arms, which I missed. It looks sort of silly, it might be obvious to you, but I missed that. So I'm going to go and make that change in a minute. The castle in between our heads is also messed up. I need to erase a little bit more of that part to just make it look a little more logical. You can see that black circle, that's actually someone's mini ear. So I undid it, undid it, and now I'm just making sure to only get the pieces that really matter, and I'll end up actually erasing a little bit more than this, because part of the castle is cut off still. So pavement is really easy to fix flaws. You can just erase the area completely and add a new area in. So what I'm doing is I'm using that same light eraser tool. I'm erasing the legs there, and then I'm later going to duplicate just a blank piece of pavement that I have in the same area and stretch it out underneath. You can rearrange the order the pictures are in, but there is a maximum file size in this app. So you'll see that runs into a problem later, but I was able to work it out. Photoshop doesn't really have a maximum file size, so that's a little more helpful. Checking into hotel loneliness, it's not what I've been used to, I confess. So we go three times a night. Talking to a stranger is nothing new. She knows how to smile but not like you. So I wait for you all night. I know that you hate it, and I hate it just as much as you, but if you can brave it, I can brave it all for you. Call me anytime you can see the lightning, don't you feel alone, you can always find me. We got a wild love, raging, lost among a million changing faces, every day our hearts keep trading places. Now I'm going back to that select tool using the paintbrush. And I'm going to use the free select tool actually to get a bigger area because of the way Mouse One's arm is. So I'm selecting this just blank area of pavement. I'm going to click it and then duplicate it. And I'm going to drag it into that blank spot. I'm going to swipe left on the side to rearrange the layers. I'm going to drag this piece out to fit. See, I actually tried to duplicate it first, but it was too many pictures. The file was too big, so instead I'm just going to drag it out completely. Now I'm just cleaning up a few details just to make it look a little more realistic. So there you have it. That's how I changed and removed the people using an additional image. This still isn't perfect. I would go back and finish a couple more details, especially kind of the castle in between our heads. I would just want to make it a little bit more perfect. But this is a pretty easy way to remove the people in the background of a crowd.